What's up, everybody? This is Sean.
This is Alan.
And this is Inside the Square, the wrestling podcast, coming at you almost every other week from sunny St. Mary's, California, Maryland. A lot to go over this, you know, that happened the last couple of weeks. A lot. So we're going to start off with the biggest news of all. Edge, it seems like he's officially retired from WWE.
He deserves it.
What do you think of Edge, Alan? When I say Edge, what do you think of?
One of the amazing heels in history. Cashed in twice.
Cashing that money in the bank.
He cashed it in on, like, The Undertaker and John Cena.
Who do you think is Edge's biggest rival?
Ooh, that's a tough one. It's between Randy Orton and The Undertaker.
I think it's Randy Orton.
Yeah.
I think it's Randy Orton.
What about with Batista?
He's had some crazy matches with Batista.
Yeah.
I think it's Randy Orton because he and Orton were partners. Then they feuded. Then they, you know.
They went back and forth
for years. And I think the last feud he had with Orton was really good, too.
Really good in 2020.
And it's a shame. And that's why I was hoping would be his last match. But yeah, it was not. It was Sheamus. And they put on a banger.
Yeah. Sheamus showed out.
Sheamus, it's interesting too, because Sheamus, you know, he's been in the company a long time.
Really long time.
That dude has been in the company forever.
He should have been an Intercontinental Champion.
He has one belt he's never won.
Yeah.
But it's interesting he's won all the other belts.
They better pull the trigger this year or next year with him.
Yeah, but back to Edge, it's interesting too. They gave him his own commemorative belts. Had studs on them. I was like, that's pretty. And they were cool looking, too.
They were awesome, yeah.
Man, those things were hot as F. And I was kind of surprised that, you know, they would go to full Monty to give him all that stuff. And then as soon as he was out, rumors start circulating.
Yeah, and he came back in 2020.
No. Rumors start circulating, like, a few days ago that this dude was in talks with AEW.
Oh.
Did you not see that?
Yeah, I saw it. I hope he does not go to AEW.
Bruh. I mean, Tony Khan is the reason he came back to WWE.
Did you know that?
He was going to sign with AEW. He went and told Vince, you know, reportedly, he went and told Vince, hey, man, I'm thinking about coming back wrestling with AEW. Anything else going on? Yeah, why don't you come sign with us? Back up the money truck and come back with us. And they did. And he's been on a tear for the last couple of years, but, you know, he's been hurt off and on. You know, he's tore his biceps.
Yeah.
You know, he's an older wrestler. He's had a lot of surgeries. He's my wife's favorite wrestler.
Yeah.
Probably one of the more original acts because, you know, he always say he's just playing himself.
Just himself.
Yeah, I remember when they were with the Brood, which was hilarious.
Yeah.
These dudes were vampires. What the hell?
I like Edge by himself.
I like the Brood.
The
I like,
ultimate opportunist.
I like Gangrel. I like freaking Christian. And uh-huh. I like Jericho and all those dudes.
I did not like that gimmick.
But, it was hilarious. I mean,
but Edge's gimmick is the ultimate opportunist.
Yeah. I mean, like I said, I could see him in AEW. He's a big name. Yeah. Older wrestler. They tend to go for big names, older wrestlers like Sting and some of the other guys. But it's a shame, like I said, that, you know, his career is winding up.
Yeah.
You know, I've been there from the beginning, and now, you know, I'm seeing the twilight of it.
Until the end.
Yeah, to the end. So it's kind of bittersweet.
Yeah.
Because it puts me in perspective, too, because I am older. You know, I'm an older wrestling fan. You know, Alan's my son. He's, you know, he's early 20s. So he's kind of grown up watching him wrestle, too. So it's a bittersweet moment. Edge is one of my favorite guys. He's been a top guy for a long time.
I liked him as a heel.
I like him as a heel too. The dude plays the hell out of the heel part.
Yeah.
He really does. But, you know, I hope if he does go to AEW, they don't misuse him. And I mean, they can't misuse him. They're gonna be paying him a lot of money.
He might go back with Christian.
I can see him, Jericho and Christian coming back together. All three.
That would be so good.
All three of those dudes, Canadians, all three of those dudes still get along, for my understanding. I think it would be a really good opportunity to bring all three of them back together.
Yeah.
And just do something crazy.
Yeah.
I could see it. But, you know, you know, on to the next topic. Jimmy Uso, do you think he's gone for real?
We're talking about Jey Uso.
I'm sorry, Jey Uso. I'm sorry about it. Thanks for correcting me. Jey Uso, do you think he's gone for real?
No. Nah, they're going to do something. Like a Fatal 4-Way match. Like, Jey Uso comes back for that.
Yeah, I don't think Jay's gone either. I know they scrubbed him from the active list and put him on the alumni list and all those stuff. And then Solo put out a statement. And I'm like, I don't think he's gone.
That's not true. No.
That's what I'm saying. I don't think he's gone. I think they're trying to work some other angle with Rikishi to come back for a little while. You know, Rikishi's still super popular.
Yeah.
Let's not fool us. Rikishi, for those who don't know, you know, maybe casual fans, Rikishi is the Usos, all three of them, Jey, Jimmy, and Solo, that's their dad. Rikishi is one of the most popular wrestlers ever in WWE.
Very popular.
Super popular. And he's with the Unanoa family. And he's, like, I think he's first cousins with Roman Reigns.
Yeah.
And he's still a super name. He comes back every now and then, and the Legends contract he has, and you know when he comes back, everyone's still doing the dances and all of the stuff.
Yeah,
people love that dude.
Yeah,
he's super popular. So I don't know how he's going to be involved in the storyline going forward. It'd be interesting to see it because Rikishi, that's one belt he's never won. He's never won the world championship, even though he's wrestled for it several times.
Yeah,
I think the biggest belt he ever won was the Intercontinental belt, and he's won the tag team belts a few times.
Yeah.
But he's a really good wrestler, man. All those Samoan dudes are really good wrestlers. I haven't seen a bad one.
No.
Ever. Ever. But he's a really good wrestler. So I'm curious to see how he's going to be involved in it. But I don't think Jey is gone. Another big news event, news item rather, Cash Wheeler. What the hell, man? This dude, this jabroni, had a road rage incident. Pulls a gun, allegedly.
Yeah.
Pulls a gun out on a, you know, flashes a gun at a. Uh oh, Alexis. Alexa, off. See, that's how sensitive this is. But Cash Wheeler allegedly had a gun, pulled it on a motorist, and the motorist called police. Hey, this maniac has a gun. He didn't know these people. It's a mess. You know, they're on the eve of a big pay-per-view.
A big mess.
Big pay-per-view and a big mess. Now Tony Khan is going to be, he's kind of painting the corner. FTR is one, those are his top guys. That's his top tag team.
I think one of them are going to get released.
They can't do that. They release one of them, they're going to have to release both of them.
Yeah.
You know, Dax Harwood.
Like, he stays out of trouble, too.
Well, that's the thing. I saw the arraignment with Cash Wheeler. And it's interesting. He'd never been in trouble.
No, it was only one time. That's it.
He had never been in trouble before. Didn't have a criminal record.
Yeah.
But he, you know, once you introduce a firearm to a situation, the chances of something bad happening goes up exponentially.
Yeah.
And he happened to have a gun on him. And he had a road rage incident. So I'm curious, you know, he turned himself in. So I'm curious, you know, was he drinking? Did he have drugs in the system? You know, it's a lot of questions I have. But, you know, if I got these questions, I know Tony Khan has the same questions. Because he's a dude that's cutting it. He's stroking a check at the end of the day.
Yeah.
I don't know what I would do in a situation like that.
I would just give the Young Bucks the titles. That's what I would do.
And that's the thing,
man. In this situation.
I root for FTR, man. Those dudes are really good at what they do. They're good ambassadors of the sport.
Yeah.
But it's just like, how do you resolve this? You know, he's going to have his day in court.
Yeah.
We weren't there. We don't know what happened. We just reading reports and news reports. But by all accounts, the dude lost it, had a gun.
Yeah.
That's not very safe.
Nope.
Not very safe. However you want to look at it, you know, and this is not a gun debate, but he did have, you know, he did flash a gun on a motorist he got upset with.
He was not found guilty at all.
Well, he hadn't been in court yet.
No.
But if you think that's right, there's something wrong with you. But Florida, a lot of stuff flies down there that don't fly nowhere else. So he might get off with a warning or some bull jive like that. Yeah. Knowing Florida, because, you know, he is a Florida man. All right, on to the next. Rey Mysterio is the new U.S. champ. That's like a week and some change old. But Rey Mysterio, they finally took the belt off of
Austin Theory.
Garbage ass Austin Theory.
But he defended the championship 10 times.
I get what you're saying, and I agree with you. But Austin Theory has the personality of a sunflower seed.
But they're going to change his gimmick.
They're going to have to do something.
Like cut him or something?
I don't think they're going to cut him. He's a really good athlete. Really good wrestler, too.
Yeah.
But he has no personality, man. He has no charisma.
You remember the cell phone gimmick?
That was good. I agree with you on that.
Yes,
that
they was should a bring good that back. Gimmick. They should bring but that
the,
back.
The problem is...
Dang it.
Logan Paul stole that gimmick.
Yeah, he did.
He did. He stole that... You know, I told someone else this, you know, in passing. I said, you know, that dude steals a lot of different moves, a lot of different ideas, and he repackages them and says that's his idea. Which is bullshit.
But I just don't agree with Rey Mysterio winning the United States Championship. It should have been Santos Escobar.
I think it's something else going on that we don't know about. Like I said, I think they're going to repackage him. Maybe as a face.
That would not work.
I think it would. Because they really patterned that guy after John Cena.
Yeah.
So I think that they're going to have to figure something out with him. But I think Rey Mysterio getting that belt and then probably feuding with Santos Escobar is a good thing.
I think Santos is going to win that belt.
Because Santos Escobar is such a good wrestler.
I want to see him turn heel on Rey Mysterio.
I remember watching him in NXT when he was the Cruiserweight Champion.
He was so good.
And Legado del Fantasma. And man, I'm telling you.
They put on a clinic.
That dude puts on a show.
Yeah.
He puts on a show. He is a high flyer, very gifted athlete too. He and Andrade remind me of a lot of each other, but, you know, he's a smaller version of Andrade.
He reminds me of Eddie Guerrero.
He does remind me of Eddie Guerrero.
Yeah.
You know, rest in peace, Eddie Guerrero.
Yeah.
Lie, cheat, steal. Awesome. Viva la Raza. But the dude, Santo Escobar has it. let's preface it by saying that he has it.
Yeah,
that dude is very fun to watch.
He's going to turn on Rey Mysterio.
I think he's going to turn on Rey Mysterio too.
Finally,
and it's going to be a mess. But I think after the mess is over with, we're going to get a good story. We're going to get a good storyline. We'll get some great matches,
and one of the best heel turns.
Yeah, because you know Rey Mysterio doesn't turn heel. He just don't do it.
I meant Santos Escobar.
Right, but I'm just saying, Rey Mysterio don't turn heel. Just like John Cena. No. They don't turn heel.
No.
Because they're good guys. They're faces. And they always will be faces. Because Mysterio, I mean, if you've seen it live, Mysterio comes to the ring, it's like, I don't know, man, it's like Christmas. Dudes turn, I mean, big burly dudes turn into like fangirls. Because that's a dude they grew up watching. You know, same, you know, we were ringside and we were like, man, that's Rey Mysterio.
Yeah.
You know, how many times you'll see that? A lot. So it's interesting, but I'm rooting for Rey. Lacy Evans, man. Other news. Lacy Evans is out at WWE.
Oh my gosh. I saw this coming.
I did not see this coming. You know, for those who don't know, Lacy Evans was out. She was out for a pregnancy. She came back. And then she kind of changed her gimmick from Southern Belle to Marine Drill Sergeant, which I thought was pretty cool.
It was cool.
Because, you know, for those who don't know.
But WWE didn't capitalize.
Lacy Evans is a Marine. She took the, you know, the Sergeant Slaughter gimmick. And like they,
some people had some complaints about it. I don't know why.
I don't know why either, because, you know.
Like, people are some haters. Come on.
Well, let me explain some to those casuals. And most people already know this. But Sergeant Slaughter was never in the Marine. He's never in the military.
No, it's never. Gimmick.
No, he was never in the Marine Corps.
No.
Never in the military. Lacy Evans was. She was a military cop.
For a long time.
Yeah. Well, I think about 5 years. Don't quote me on that, but I think about 5 years. But she did serve. She did service to her country in uniform, which is different than Sergeant Slaughter.
Yeah.
So let's back that up. And now we unpack that. Think about this. She was killing it. She competed for the world championship
multiple times.
Several times.
Yes. they did not capitalize for some reason.
And she was popular.
Too popular.
I won't go too popular, but she was good, and she put on some good matches.
Yeah.
Fun to watch. Very fun to watch. I really liked her. I think that gimmick with the, you know, being the Marine and the drill sergeant and stuff, I think that kind of, like you pointed out, I agree with that point that some people didn't like it and it was unpopular in certain circles. But I do think she has talent, and I don't understand why. And then after they cut her, well, not cut her, after they separated, they said, oh, she doesn't have a non-compete clause. Why would you not give a non-compete clause to one of your top tier guys, people rather?
She might go to AEW or something.
I think that's, I don't know, man.
NWA.
I could see that too, but I think she'd do better in like Impact or AEW. What do you think?
I think in Impact.
I think she'd do better in Impact as well.
Yeah.
Going on to Impact, Trinity is killing it.
She's killing it lately, yeah.
She's killing it, man. She's probably the most popular wrestler they have in that company right
now. She beat Deonna Purrazza pretty clean.
That was a good match, man.
Yeah.
That was a good match. But I'm telling you right now, Trinity Fatu is killing it. For those who don't know, Trinity, and you I know you dirty, you filthy casuals know. You know Trinity Fatu is formerly Naomi. But I really think that she's probably the most popular wrestler they've had there in some time.
Yeah.
She has interest, casual interest, passing interest, and people tune in to watch her. People follow her on Instagram. She's very popular. She dances. She's good at the mic. She does a lot of stuff you wish your superstar, your champ would do. And I really think that it's coming back to bite WWE in the ass that they lost Trinity, they lost Mercedes Moné, and now they've lost Lacy Evans, and they're probably gonna lose some more.
Yeah, like Charlotte Flair.
Yeah, and don't get me the line. They have some top stars in the women's division. The women's division is stacked. I mean,
it's kind of stacked in NXT, but it's different.
Yeah, Io Sky. She's awesome. She just won the championship, cashing it in. She's awesome. She's one of the better wrestlers, not female or male. She's one of the better wrestlers you'll ever see because she's special. I mean,
how long is she going to have that title
for? I think she's going to have it until the end of the year.
Yeah.
I really do.
That's fair.
I think she's going to have it until the end of the year. She's a special talent, very gifted aerial assaults. I mean, she is incredible in the air. And she's like, the Japanese wrestlers are really talented wrestlers. They're very technical wrestlers.
Like Asuka.
Asuka is special, man.
Man, they kind of screwed her over, but it's okay. It's okay. They made it up. They made it up this time.
Yeah, Asuka has a really good presence. She has a really good presence online.
Like, she comes every single day.
Yeah, and you made a mention of NWA. Shout out to Camille. She is the longest reigning women's champion in NWA history.
She is killing it.
800 and some odd days. Oh, my God. She's incredible.
Nobody's not going to catch that record.
I don't think nobody's going to ever catch that record. 800 and some days, B?
Like, who's going to dethrone her?
I don't know, man. Because I was thinking about that, too. Just like we always say, you know, if someone has a belt and they're that popular like she is, I don't know anybody else on that roster who has the wherewithal to take that belt and do what she's doing with it, because she's an ambassador.
Yeah.
People like her.
Yeah.
I mean, she has a good online presence, too, because people really pay attention to what she's doing. I think that she's going to be constrained in NWA unless she goes to someone like AEW or WWE. And I don't think...
I think AEW would be better.
I don't think that she should go to WWE because they might put her in NXT or something stupid like that.
She would be too popular.
I think that she's a polished champ and she should go straight to the roster. Yeah. But, you know, I'm not in talent division, but she is really, really good. One last thing before we wrap it up, Nick Aldis is in talks with WWE.
That could happen.
I saw it, you know, allegedly. I saw it on a report on the wire, and it kind of shook me out because we had just talked about it a few weeks ago that he might, you know, could sign with WWE. He probably would sign with WWE because he left Impact so suddenly.
Yeah, he did.
And he didn't get the belt, which is crazy because the dude is uber champ. He's really good.
He was very polished.
Yeah, he NWA champ forever.
2 years.
Yeah, that's a long time, B. And he's not going back to NWA. He's not going to go to AEW. Well, he could go to AEW.
He would be too good.
He's already polished.
Yeah.
So I'm curious to see if they're going to give him the LA Knight treatment and put him over and send him to the top of the card. I think he'd be a really good addition, especially with the, you know, talent that's going on right now. I think he'd be really good.
Yeah.
You got any save rounds? Anything else you want to talk about, Big Butt?
I just want Roman Reigns to lose that title so bad.
That's Alan's weekly prayer to the wrestling gods. Roman Reigns lose that belt. God, boy, you are very 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 predictable. But I love you.
He's been champ for like almost 3 years. Oh my gosh.
Too funny. All right, guys. Until next time. See you down the road.
Bye.